Hello and welcome to this video on green technologies for electricity generation in buildings. We will review together technologies such as photovoltaics, wind turbines, cogeneration, and how they fit with buildings. We'll see also how storage can be an important complement. Let's start with photovoltaics, a leading renewable energy technology with several benefits. Solar energy is unlimited and available worldwide. It does not emit greenhouse gases or other pollutants during operation. Photovoltaic systems are silent and require little maintenance. Photovoltaics are also a good fit for buildings. They can be installed on the roof, in the car park, or even integrated into the building architecture. Most buildings have the technical potential to produce as much as or even more electricity than they consume. The production capacity of a photovoltaic system depends on the available surface to install the solar panels and on the size and the power output of these panels. For example, on an available rooftop area of 1,000 square meters, a photovoltaic system composed of standard 300-watt solar panels has a maximum power output of 175 kilowatts. To estimate the real power output, additional factors such as building location, panel orientation, temperature, and losses must be taken into account. Wind turbines are another fast-growing renewable energy technology. Despite their huge energy potential, not many wind turbines are found on car parks or on building roofs. And when they are, they typically are characterized by a small production capacity, usually not exceeding 10 kilowatts. The reason for this is that wind turbines are efficient when the wind flow is uniform and relatively constant. But in urban environments, wind conditions are highly variable and quite turbulent, which significantly decreases their efficiency. Noise and vibrations are an additional challenge to using wind turbines in buildings. Combined heat and power, also called cogeneration, is an energy production system generating both electricity and heat. This technology is energy efficient and it's a good fit for buildings. This is especially true for building complexes or campuses where it answers the demand for heat and also generates electricity. These combined heat and power systems increase the primary energy utilization factor and reduce the greenhouse gas emissions. Moreover, the primary energy source used can be a renewable one, for example, biogas or biofuel. The local electricity generation solutions I just described provide more sustainable electrical energy. But they also have some drawbacks. Most significantly, the variability of energy production depending on weather conditions. This is where storage can be an important complement. When you produce more electricity than your building consumes, you can store the excess in an electrical energy storage system. You can use this later when the demand exceeds production. In addition, electrical storage systems let you optimize energy billing, shave peaks, provide voltage and frequency support to the grid, and may even serve the building's critical loads during a grid outage. In summary, we have reviewed several green electricity generation technologies, how they fit to buildings, and how storage can be a useful complement. Note that buildings engaged in developing their sustainability often opt to include a combination of these technologies. This is a good way to maximize their respective benefits, especially when the energy produced is used for self-consumption. I hope that this video was useful for you. learn more about electrical installations with photovoltaic production for self-consumption in our next videos. Thank you for watching and see you soon!